Hi everyone, I'm Sheridan Nichols and welcome back to Inside Bristol. We're so excited to have you join us today, and we're kicking off today's show with Karen Boyd. She is the site coordinator for the Family Justice Center. Thank you so much, Karen, for being here today and talking with us.
Thank you for having
me. We're excited to have you. So you've got some really great news to share with all of us today.
Yeah. So the Family Justice Center project was started here in Sullivan County last July, and this past month, Mr. Jim Street of J.A. Street Associates donated a building for us to use for our Family Justice Center when we open. So we're very excited about that.
And I'm sure, had you been in, I guess, the market looking for a building?
Yes, I can't tell you how many times I had driven around Blountville. District Attorney General Barry Staubus drove me around a lot. I enlisted the help of Realtor Roby Gardner, who is near Johnson City, and we looked at so many buildings. I had thought it would take us a year to find an appropriate building and raise the funds for it. And then Mr. Street showed up and said, here's a building. It met all the needs that our survivor focus groups had told us, and signed on the dotted line. I paid $60 for 5 years, and
wow,
we're in.
Well, this is exciting, and it is in Blountville. Is that correct?
Yes.
And you said it's really quite the building, and it's really
a little bit fancy and nice and big. It's about a little over 4,000 square feet. It's got lots of different rooms, which we need for the agencies that'll be represented on site. And it's located at the end of a dead-end road in a really sweet little subdivision, which will give our clients a lot of anonymity and privacy, where you don't have to worry about, you know, your aunt riding past on her way to Food City and being like, what are you doing at the Family Justice Center? So we're really excited about the location.
Oh, that is exciting. So when do you think you'll actually officially open up the doors?
Well, technically under the terms of our grant, we have to open by July of 2018. So we're really ahead of schedule. And I had started saying, well, maybe we'll open by next March. But now I'm thinking we might be able to open by the end of this year, depending on how fundraising goes.
Oh, that is great. Yeah. I'm so excited for you.
Thank you.
I can tell you're so excited.
I am.
I mean, we're all excited. It's always good whenever we can do something wonderful and positive in our community. And tell everyone, in case they're not familiar with the Family Justice Center, tell us a little bit about, you know, the importance of this building and what you all do.
Okay, well, the first Family Justice Center was opened in the United States in 2002. Okay, and that was opened in San Diego. And the theory behind the Family Justice Center is that it makes it easier for victims of domestic violence and family abuse to get help. So it's one place that gathers up all the services that are already offered in the community and physically puts them under one roof, so that when we have people that are dealing with family violence problems, they can come one place and be told, here are all the services available to you. Let's see, what does safety look like for you? What does freedom look like for you? And we'll make sure that you can access all of those services that you need in a safe and easy way.
So what are some of the services that will go into this new building?
Well, all three of our local law enforcement agencies will have representation on site, which is great. Legal Aid of East Tennessee is one of our partners, so they'll have an attorney or paralegal on site, which is big for us, because right now there's an attorney in Johnson City who covers Sullivan County, but I'm sure she's going to love to have an actual desk and space here in Sullivan County. The Children's Advocacy Center is only about a mile and a half from our center, but they will be one of our partners. Safe House, which is our domestic violence service provider in Kingsport, and Abuse Alternatives, which is the domestic violence service provider here in Bristol, will be on site as well. And then the District Attorney's Office will have representation there. And we're working with vocational rehabilitation people, and we'll be working off-site with drug rehabilitation as well. So pretty much everything that we can think of, all these services that may be needed, we want to have available.
So I'm sure this is a little bit of a dream come true for you.
It really is. When I was in college, I was actually trained as a rape crisis counselor. And ever since then, all through law school and through my legal career, abused children and the elderly and people our age who are in abusive relationships have really just pulled at my heartstrings. And here in Sullivan County, it is a problem. And I'm excited to have this service available. Statistically, Family Justice Centers make a huge difference in a community when they open. And I'm really excited for what this is going to mean for our county.
Well, I'm excited too. Well, you'll have to come back on as it gets closer. And Karen mentioned us going on a tour, so that would be great too. So we're really just so happy for you, and what an amazing thing to donate. And I'm sure you're all just thrilled. So you'll have to just keep us posted on when the doors actually officially open so we can make that announcement to all of you.
All right, I sure will. Thank you very much.
Is there anything that I'm missing that you'd like to add today?
You know, I just want to say that we have gotten so much support from the local community. Here in Bristol, Chief Wade Reed has agreed to serve on our board of directors. He's been very involved. Lieutenant Debbie Richmond at the police department has been involved. Bristol Regional Medical has actually donated medical equipment to our center to be used in the forensic medical suite. The Home Depot here, Johnny Brusco's, and people have just really been so generous, and we really appreciate that, and it speaks very highly of Bristol.
That is great. Oh, well, Karen, congratulations.
Thank you.
And thank you for sharing that with us. And we are excited to share that with you. And stay where you are. We'll be right back.